Hello dear student, today we are going to discuss the introduction to pharmacognosy. Myself Dr. Mohan Kolaskar from R.C. Patel Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research. So as we know that there are basically four subjects in pharmacy, that are pharmaceutics, pharmaceutical chemistry, pharmacology and pharmacognosy. So if you see the origin of pharmacognosy, it can be considered as one of the oldest branch in the pharmacy. As with the evolution of human beings, the human beings are mainly dependent on plants as the food, for the food purpose. So here with the evolution of human beings, the plants are being utilized as the article for the as a food article. With the experiences with the human being, they can categorize this plant material, plants, as in the two categories, that is useful plants and harmful plants. And these harmful plants are nothing but, we can say, toxic plants, and useful plants are nothing but the nutritional plants. As their experience increases, there are a few percentage of population, they were practicing these practicing with the plants for the purpose of treatment of certain diseases. And thus the herbal practitioners are being existed into the world. And these herbal practitioners, they are becoming a pioneer in the identification and utilization of such kinds of plants. These herbal practitioners, furthermore, they have categorized these plants as a herbal plant, that is nothing but poisonous plant, edible plants, which is nothing but a nutritional plants, and a medicinal plants. So medicinal plants are nothing but the plants which can have an ability to cure the diseases. And these herbal practitioners, with their experiences, they develop their own principles, and this principle later resulted to development of the alternative system of medicine into the globe. Before going to the actual introduction to pharmacognosy, now we are going to discuss here what is meant by crude drug. Because this crude drug terminology, you are going to come across with this throughout your subject. So what is crude drug? A crude drug is nothing but a drug of vegetable origin or animal origin that have undergone only the process of collection and drying. I will tell you with the example here. So everyone knows that tulsi has a medicinal property. So the tulsi leaf, when it is collected by hand plucking method and subjected for drying, either by an artificial controlled temperature drying or the shade drying or sun drying, the resultant product after the collection process and drying process are nothing but a dried tulsi leaves. So these are called as the tulsi leaf crude drug. Now we will see here some of the contributors into the pharmacognosy. So there are basically six contributors we have identified as the major contributors in the development of pharmacognosy. As we discussed in the first slide, that these traditional practices, they developed their own principles to practice the herbal medicinal plants and develop the different alternative system of medicine. So here there are two contributors from the India, that is, one is Charak, another one is Shirpur. Charak has did an enormous work in anatomy physiology, as well as he categorized the medicinal plants into the different categories depending upon the disease conditions. And he has wrote in the book called as Charak Sahita, that is nothing but the materia medica, in English we can call it as. And they have given the medicinal preparation can be, which are being utilized for the treatment of different diseases. The Shirpur Sahita, he is also the physician by profession, or we can say herbal medicine practitioners, but his proficiency is in the surgical practices. So he also known as the father of surgery. So he has written a Shirpur Sahita where he has been elaborately given the instruments which are being utilized in the surgical procedures, as well as he also combined the medicinal plants. Hippocrates, who has been working in European countries in between 460 to 360 BC, who is by profession a physician who has compiled the drugs, and he is known to be father of medicine. Aristotle, who has written enormous work in the animal drugs, his period is 384 to 322 BC. Dioscorid, who has compiled the medicinal plants, and he has wrote a book, that is De Materia Medica. And Galen, he is known to be father of, first pharmacist of the world, because he has been excellent at different extraction procedures, as well as he has been given the different procedures for the preparation of medicinal product in the concentrate form. So you will find the details of these contributors into our books. So if you read it, you will get an idea what is their contribution. But up to this, the term pharmacognosy has not been come into the existence. As we have been discussing the first slide, that the medicinal plants have been utilized or have been used for medicinal purposes from a time immemorial. But the first time a German chemist or German pharmacist who has been coined the term pharmacognosy in 1815, as he was been publishing his work with the title Analectica Pharmacognostica. So he has been first time used the word pharmacognostica, and he has took this word from the Greek language, in which he has been utilized the two Greek words to coin the pharmacognostica term. So he, according to him, pharmacon is nothing but a drug, and gnosiko is nothing but the acquire the knowledge. So if you combine these two words, the meaning will be acquiring the knowledge about the drug. So that is nothing but a pharmacognosy. So what is pharmacognosy then? Pharmacognosy is nothing but the systematic and scientific study of characteristic of crude drug, as well as the study of history of the crude drug, methods of cultivation and collection of the crude drugs, and the preparation of crude drugs. So these, the pharmacognosy deals with the four things. So you should define the pharmacognosy in a systematic manner. The pharmacognosy is defined as the scientific and systematic study of the structural, physical, chemical, and biological characteristics of crude drugs, along with their history, method of cultivation, collection, and preparation for the market. So in layman language, what we can say is pharmacognosy. The pharmacognosy is nothing but study of a drug from natural origin. So if you see, we have been seeing the historical contributors into that, but after coming into the 19th century, the pharmacognosy has been changed in a lot, because of there are some milestones in the field of pharmacognosy. So these milestones are nothing but the development of the different methods of extraction of active chemical constituent from the plants. And another milestone is phytochemical isolation. The chemists are now from 1860, the chemists are able to isolate the different kinds of chemical present in the plant, like alkaloid, glyphosate, and the list is goes on. Also along with that, there was the development in the pharmacognosy is nothing but the development of the methods of plant tissue cultures. So plant tissue culture is nothing but the developing the complete plant into the laboratory, okay, from any part of the mother plant. So here the farmers or here the cultivators need not to be depend upon the climatic constraints. So the plant tissue culture is one of the milestone turning point into the development of pharmacognosy. Later on, the chromatographic techniques, which will helps to identify the different kinds of phytochemicals present into the plants, as well as lastly, that is in vitro assays. So in vitro assays are nothing but the assays which can be carried out either enzymatic level or either a receptor level, which will make the evaluate the crude drug for the therapeutic purposes in a very short period of time. Okay, and these are the some milestone which leads to take the pharmacognosy into the different heights. Okay, then in this chapter, in the first chapter, again there are two alternative system of medicines has been added. That is nothing but an Ayurvedic system of medicine and Siddha system of medicine. If you see this, both system of medicines are Indian system of medicine. It is being practiced in India. Principles are developed into the India. Okay, so almost both are the same system of medicine. The only things are that the Ayurvedic system of medicine has been practiced by Aryans and Siddha system of medicine has been practiced by Dravidians. Ayurvedic system of medicines are considered to be a part of Veda, that is, it is considered to be Upaveda of Atharveda and highly practiced in the northern part of India. They are basically based upon the principles like Tridosha theory, that is Vata Pitta Kapha, Panchamahabhuta theory or five elements theory, and Saptadhatu theory. Here the diagnosis and treatment has been carried out based upon the Ashtanga Nidana. So according to Ayurvedic system of medicine, there are eight characteristics has to be observed to find out the disease condition into the human beings. Here the medicine which are being used into the Ayurvedic system of medicine are, it has been first practice which is being carried out as a part of treatment is Panchakarma, that is a Shuddhi of a human body. Then there are some limitations into the diet, that is Ahar Vihar. Then medicine has been prescribed which of different types like in Churna, Vati, Gutika. So this is what an Ayurvedic system of medicine. Siddha system of medicines are practice in India by Siddhars. Siddhars are nothing but these are the people who has got a Siddhi, okay, called as a Siddhars. So this is actually practice in the southern part of India. It is most widely practiced in Tamil Nadu. At present, it is being practiced in Tamil Nadu and the Kerala. Okay. It is also called as Dravidian system of medicine. They are based upon the similar principle, that is three guna theory and Panchamahabhuta theory. Here again the diagnosis for the treatment has been carried out based upon the Ashtanga Nidana and medicines practice similar, that is Panchakarma, Ahar Vihar, and the different type of medicines are being utilized. Okay, you will find the details of all the things what we have been discussed in our book for the diploma. You can refer for that. Thank you.